Anka Domain is from Brazilian blog Brita.com. I'm Shane from the 6-Point Brewery. First of all, it's a pleasure to be here in Brazil. What are you expecting and thinking about this event?
Well, this is probably one of the highlights of the entire trip so far. We're here at what we would call Ground Zero. This is where the real craft beer movement is taking place. And just so your viewers out there, this is a Sunday afternoon. We're going to be the beer laboratory and it's a dual purpose brewery homebrew supply shop. We got a little kind of like a impromptu barbecue going on. So yeah, this is inspiring stuff.
Oh, nice.
So, and how is
Cerveja? Yeah. Cerveja. Ah, yeah. And how starts the idea to make a collaborative
beer? This guy right here, Donald's, who's our friend and business partner, and made an introduction to Cerveja Mia, and they sent the beers over to Brooklyn. They tasted them. Had a little communication online with one web chat and two emails, and then we got an idea. They like to make really nice, hot, aggressive beers, and we like to make really full-flavored hoppy beers, so we figured we'd join forces and make a proper American-style IPA in Brazil.
And what's the new beers are coming to Brazil from Sitola?
So there's several. Yeah.
Oh,
so nice. First of all, there's a beer that was actually it's been people were tasting in Brazil, or I should say, at least one person.
Yeah.
Katia from
Katia Zanatti.
Exactly. She participated in a global tasting of a beer called That's one of the beers. And then we have the High Res, which I know Brazil is familiar with the resin.
Yeah.
High Res
is Niger.
Sure. Yeah. So the High Res is the related to the resin. But I'd say they are brothers from a different mother. But that beer is being liberated, I think, this week. So that beer is as well.
Last question, have you tasted a few Brazilian beers, and what's your favorite?
There's a lot of good ones out there. So, the best opportunity to taste many Brazilian beers for us was at the Blumenau Beer Festival, and a couple really stood out. Carlos will probably remember the names. One of them was a beer that was made with coffee beans. See, most of the time when you make a coffee beer, it's very dark beer.
Arábica.
It's red.
That's it.
From what?
The Arábica. So, the Arábica was a coffee beer that looked like a pale ale. But when you smelled it, it smelled like coffee. Right. It tasted a little bit like it too. I couldn't really tell if you got any caffeine effects from it because it was very late at night. But we had a lot of beer prior to that. I remember that was very good. Then there was a beer that Carlos gave me that had chili peppers in it.
From Barco, hot lager, yes.
That was also very interesting. Right now I'm just naming the more exotic beers. But there were also good beers that were just very well executed for the style. What was that? The IPA that we had that was, I think it won like the award for the best IPA.
It was just a regular pale ale.
Yeah, and it was so good. It was a crushable, dry, bitter, really good aroma on it. It was a great beer, and the brewer was really nice. It's kind of, I don't remember the names of these breweries, but I remember the taste.
Okay.
And then there was one gentleman, his name was Sun Brown.
Brown.
He gave us an entire line of beers, and they ranged from pretty good to phenomenal. So the for a lot of the beers. So we had another beer that was made with, was it passion fruit or?
Maracujipo.
Maracujipo.
Los Cabezas, yes.
Yeah. And they had a single strength version and then they had a double.
Yes.
Yeah. And I like the double a little better. It was even more intense than the. They were both good, but the double was spectacular. So there's a lot of cool stuff going on. Yeah. It's always interesting too because when you visit other places, it's like you expose your ears to different music, you expose your eyes to different sights, but then when your palate tastes different beers that you've never had before. When I go back home, it makes me inspired to try to make new things, you know? Like push the frontiers, try to create new formulas, you know? So this has been very inspirational.
Oh, nice. Shane, thanks for this interview. It's a pleasure to sit in. See you if we will be. Cheers!
Cheers.
E é isso aí, aqui o pessoal vem tomar e curtir.
A ideia é fazer isso com mais frequência?
Ó, a ideia é fazer a cada 3 meses ter um BH, um a cada estação, para poder trazer cervejas novas, às vezes pratos diferentes ou até chefes paulistas que tenham ideias e reinterpretar.